Okay, so let's start at the beginning. A month or two ago, I sketched a few side profiles of myself, and I believe that is when my whole side profile obsession started. This was also when an idea popped into my head to try to do polymer clay pins. One drawing that started it all was actually this one, and some of you might recognize it from my illustration process video. Anyway, I started experimenting with side profiles, adding some values to them with a blending stump. I wasn't actually really trying to design a pin at this point. I was just having fun trying to draw some faces that would be both creepy and a bit cute. Most importantly, I was trying to find shapes that would be unique, that would separate these characters from one another. Instead of going for bald heads like I almost always do, I gave those guys hair. This was also another element that would separate them from each other, give them another distinctive feature. My biggest inspiration at this point was definitely makeup and hair from like Louis XIV or Stanisław Leszczyński. I think that there are two things I want you to take away from this video. One is that inspiration is literally everywhere. The idea of adding hair appeared in my head after watching a documentary series about Louis XIV and Louis XV. Something that was also floating in my head was the movie Le Roi Danse, as well as Ridicule and Amadeus. If you are a fan of costume dramas, by all means binge all of those movies if you can find them. They are masterpieces. Anyway, a lot of images from those movies were floating my head, as well as some old portrait paintings from the French court. It all started to materialize in those weird hair shapes and very dark lips and grimaces and smug faces and double chins. I think that experience kind of reassured me in a way. I believe that as artists, we have to have time to consume media and process it. I have a tendency to blame myself for not working when I'm watching something or playing games because I feel like I'm wasting time. But like really, in order to produce something, I also need to take something in. And yeah, I know this, yet experience like this really show me that this is important. Actually giving yourself a break and enjoying a good movie or a documentary, or even flipping a bit mindlessly through Pinterest or art books or meet museums online collection, really do help in expanding your visual library. And it's just easier to work later. Second thing is that sketching really does pay off. It really has happened time and time again for me. I sketch something out of nowhere, it's just a small, meaningless doodle, and a week or a month or sometimes even a half a year later, it transforms into a cool idea for something way bigger. And if you don't have a habit of sketching regularly or you have never tried having a sketchbook, I really highly recommend it. Okay, a few days later, I was set on making clay pins. This time I wanted to actually try and design some shapes and faces that would be simple enough to make them into pins. So yeah, simple shapes, funny faces, and most importantly, color. I decided to try my luck at doing faces up front, something like the vase guy I did some time ago. I got out my kuretake brush pen and started scribbling some grimaces on colorful shapes. I thought that doing a lot of faces on one sheet with already set head shapes would make me work a bit faster and, well, see if this is actually a good idea for a pin. I think this is often proposed as an exercise for illustrators and animators to try and fill shapes with different visages and work as quickly as you can. And even after filling like only 4 pages, I already felt a bit more comfortable with coming up with ideas for different, I guess, characters that would become the subjects of my clay pins. A few days later, a small doodle in my sketchbook caught my eye. I knew those hatted guys were missing something, and this small dude made me realize it was actually values. But it still wasn't it, Chief. something was literally calling me to take up site profiles again. And I don't know what it is, but they look so funny and so creepy to me. They have much more character, I think, and are a bit uglier and less perfect than those front faces. I kind of wanted to do the same types of drawings as before, but honestly, it was really pointless. I didn't even know why I wanted to try and do some new designs when I literally had an entire library of site profiles to choose from. I think it was rather me trying to procrastinate on doing the actual final designs. Anyway, after sketching a bit, both with a pencil and colored pencils, I finally gathered up the courage to paint. I took a small piece of tracing paper and transferred the original sketch onto a blank page. I wanted to have a bit more space than in my sketchbook and work on developing a color palette, and that is why I decided to just multiply the same design several times. At this point, I knew that I probably want the hair and the skin to be complementary, mostly because those colors would contrast each other well and make everything pop. I wasn't dead set on a complementary palette though. I also wanted to experiment a little bit and not be too strict with myself. I was still having lots of fun, just like fumbling around trying to come up with a simple but a memorable personage. Still, there were some rules I set up for myself. Rule number one was simplicity. I wanted the faces to be simple because of two reasons. One, I wanted to do one design on multiple pins. A simple design would make duplicating the whole painting and drawing process easier. And two, to save time. I didn't want to spend more than like two and a half hours on drawing one pin, so keeping the design fairly simple would help to speed up the process. Rule number two was good contrast between the values and the colors. And as I said, I wanted to make those pins really pop. Since they are going to be worn pinned to a piece of clothing and viewed from far away, I knew they needed to be a bit more saturated and have a bit more contrast than my usual works. I wanted the faces to be easily readable from afar, so eyes and lips became my main points of focus. By the way, you might be wondering why I'm using colored pencils in there. A year ago, I made a few clay pins, or rather just clay pieces. They were my learning ground. I experimented a bit with how the watercolors and gouaches work with them. I even did the one that had paint scratched off, which was actually kind of cool. But my biggest discovery is that you can actually use colored pencils. This technique has its pros and cons, and I'm gonna go over them in detail in the next video, where I'll be doing clay pins following the designs from this video. So you know what to do. Subscribe to join my dudes club. All right. Time for a small Q&A, because I asked you on Instagram to send me some questions, and you did, and I'm very happy about that, so. I've always been into drawing faces. I was told from an early age that I'm particularly good at drawing portraits, but weirdly enough, I've always felt that I was actually pretty bad at drawing faces, especially when I was like 13 and in my anime phase. But yeah, they were always my favorite thing to draw, and basically all of my sketchbooks are filled to the brim with faces and portraits of, well, mostly strangers and myself. Probably chips or French fries. I love mashed potatoes though. But yeah, I'm a huge chips lover, or crisps, if you will. I've been actually drawing ever since I can remember. My mom's an artist, and I think I was just raised as an artsy kid. You know, like always running around, drawing, painting, embroidering random stuff. Yeah, my mom got me into art, actually. Thank you, mommy, by the way. My favorite artists, well, get ready for me being a pretentious art student, and sorry for mispronouncing those names. Peter Bruegel, Uccello, Piero della Francesca, Pontormo, Bosch, Van Eyck, and from contemporary artists, people I mostly follow on Instagram, Andrea Serio, Feral Kid, Flaffaun, and Nicolas Menard. Thank you. That may be weird, but when I draw, there's usually one or two thoughts stuck in a loop inside my head that make absolutely no sense, and I don't know what it is, but my mind cannot handle drawing and thinking at the same time. I think it's mostly consistency and being active. I usually post once a week, or sometimes twice or more, and being active is posting on stories, commenting on other artists' posts, and reacting to stories of other people. I think a lot of my followers are followers of my art buddies on Instagram, so yeah, I think it's mostly reaching out to people and connecting with other small artists like yourself. I think it might be etching, like, as in the traditional printmaking method, I don't really enjoy the process. There you go! Old stuff when Sophie was very carefree and very young. I love your tapestry pieces.
Aw, thank you.
Number one would be drawing from life, also converting paintings to black and white and studying why some values work and some don't. I learned a lot from modern day James and Marco Bucci. They have excellent tutorials on values. I mean, this is just general advice, but I think what helped me the most is to always keep myself in check, like try and see if those values I'm using make the image better or worse, trying to balance the contrast, and working a lot in black and white. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, if you want to see how these designs are going to be transformed into actual clay pens, don't forget to join my dudes club. Like the video if you liked it. Thank you again, and see you next time. Bye!